The light won't work.
The electricity's off, Jen.
Don't move. I know where it is.
Ow!
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
There we go.
Well, what do you think?
Oh, Greg, it's quaint.
I just knew you'd love it. This is just the place for us, Jen.
Where's the kitchen?
Right through here.
Look, you can pass stuff right through. The fridge and stove are prehistoric, but they work.
Well, have you turned the heat on yet? It's quite chilly in here.
You don't exactly turn the heat on. You sort of jump it up, throw it in, and toss in a match.
A wood stove.
Real country living. Evenings curled up by a crackling fire.
But you don't even know how to use a wood stove.
Sure I do. It's just like a barbecue.
What's that?
Gasoline. Much cheaper than lighter fluid.
I thought people used paper and twigs and things like that.
That was before science discovered more combustible materials. You just let it soak in for a minute.
You know, a wood stove might be fun.
And throw in a match.
The system still has a few flaws in it.
I thought this was supposed to calm my nerves.
Silly of me. It's an enclosed space.
Well, I think I'll make some coffee. Is there any coffee in this house?
Lots, but you sit down. I'll make it.
Do you know how long it's been since I indulged in the simple pleasure of making my husband a coffee? So sit, relax. Do we have any cream?
Yeah, there's some in the fridge.
From now on, I'll be making you all the coffee you like. Greg, are you glad I'm back?
Of course.
I know that it was my fault mostly, but I really do want this to be a new start for us.
It wasn't all your fault. The doctor said if I'd communicated a little more.
If I do anything to annoy you, you must tell me. Don't keep it inside.
I won't. I've changed, you know? And out here, it'll all be different. We'll have time for each other.
I wish you told me, though.
Told you? Told you what?
That you rented a place in the country.
But it makes perfect sense. I can take my sabbatical and you can recover.
There's just no people around here.
Sure there is. This isn't the wilderness, you know. There's plenty of farms around here and the village is only 5 miles away. Look, it's your first day out of the hospital. Naturally, you're feeling tense.
Let me put some music on. That'll relax you. What would you like?
Oh, just something soothing. You know, as we were driving out here tonight, every town that we passed, I kept thinking, this is it. This has to be it. But then the towns grew smaller, and soon there was nothing. And the sun went down, it was just our lone headlights on the dark highway. It was like going down a long, dark tunnel. Funny. I never thought I'd miss the noise and the lights of the city, but I do. It's amazing. Greg? Greg? Greg, where are you?
Jen. What is it? What's wrong?
You nearly scared me to death.
I was just bringing your luggage in. There's a back stairway.
It's crazy. I thought you'd... Look, it's the first time I've been left alone since I got out of the hospital.
It's a natural reaction, Jen. Once we've settled in...
It's the isolation of this place. I just need people around me right now.
Well, we aren't completely alone. There's George just across the way. He's the farmer I rented this place from. He's a real character. You'll love him. And when Sis arrives, you'll have her to talk to.
What?
Said the farmer across the street is a real character.
Oh, Craig, no, not Laura.
She won't be staying long.
We need to work things out with us. Surely she understands that.
It's just for a few days.
That's what she said the last time. You know what happened then.
She likes you. She wants to patch things up between you.
She likes you, not me.
I don't understand your attitude towards her. Look, she's moving out west. This may be the last chance I get to see her for years, maybe.
She's moving out west.
Yes. She's given up her job, sold her car and everything. How could I tell her not to come?
Not ready for it, Greg. Really, I'm not.
Well, I could stop her now, even if I wanted to.
What do you mean?
She's on the bus. She's coming here tonight.
She's coming here tonight?
Unless the bus is late.
Greg, how could you let her talk you into this?
Really, Jen, you misjudged her completely.
She'll take over this whole house. She'll take over you again.
It's not gonna be like that again. Okay? I promise.
But if I can't take it, you will send her away.
Of course. But it's not gonna come to that again. Okay? Go get that coffee. Should be ready by now.
All right. I'm not looking forward to it, though. Where'd you like it?
Ah! Oh!
Hello, hello! How are the lovebirds? Oh, excuse me.
George, come in.
I saw the lights on. Is everything all right?
Yes, fine. Don't mind that, George.
So, Mr. Sanderson, this must be your new bride?
Yes. She's not exactly new, though, George.
I know what you mean, Mr. Sanderson. Very few of them are these days. But, I'm liberal-minded, so what the heck.
Jen, this is George.
Pleased to meet you.
You'll have your hands full there. So, when was the wedding?
What wedding?
But I thought...
We've been married for 6 years.
6 years?
We just haven't been together in a while.
Well, I see. Anyways, is everything all right?
Yes, everything's fine.
Place is still a bit dusty, ain't it? Yep, dries the mouth right out. Yes, sir, very dry indeed.
Would you like a drink, George?
The coffee's ready.
Coffee? Sorry, my doctor says it's too stimulating.
Tea?
Brings me out in a rash.
How about a whiskey?
Now you're talking. Small mug will do fine. Yep, it's a good old house. No leaks or nothing. Bought it for my boy Robert a few years back, but he wasn't too keen on farming, so I just rent the place out to folks now. I'm sure you'll like it here. The last bunch sure did. That was, till the ghosts.
Ghosts?
I don't believe in them myself, Mrs. Sanderson. But these were city folk, and they had obviously read too much.
Well, what ghosts?
Well, about 50 years ago, there was a ghastly murder in this very room. It was a young woman, about your age.
What was that, George?
He said that there was a murder in this very room.
A long time ago.
How fascinating.
I hope you folks don't believe in ghosts.
Of course not. To me, a ghost is just a chemical in someone's brain.
Well, I'm glad you feel that way. This house has scared a lot of people off over the years. It's ghosts, mainly. And the blood.
Blood?
Was this young woman. Found her lying in a pool of her own blood. And now whenever there's a murder around, they say the floor turns red.
Did they ever catch him?
Nope, never did. But folks around here claim they've seen him.
Surely, he'd have died long ago.
Well, it's the ghost they say they see. They also say you should never go up to the quarry at night, and you should never stay in this house. I really shouldn't be telling you that, should I?
They actually see this murderer.
Well, no. They hear him. It's like a heartbeat noise, but louder. Then he's supposed to appear with a long, blood-stained knife.
Oh, my God.
I think you should change the subject, George.
Makes you nervous, don't it?
It's Jan. She has a very vivid imagination.
No, I'm fine. It's fascinating, really.
Don't worry, enough.
Not at all.
What in tarnation?
Careful, George. That's one of my machines.
What the hell is it for?
For measuring flints.
Flints?
For making Stone Age tools. It's part of my studies in lithic technology.
Ah.
The study of making things out of rocks.
Oh, so that's what you and the other fella are doing up there in the quarry.
Yes. That's Jan's father. He's the head of the department at the university. Let me show you how this works.
Greg, I'm sure George doesn't need a rundown on your PhD.
No. I'm very interested in your scholarly pursuits. I'm a bit of a scholar myself, actually. My boy Robert, heard him go on for hours and hours without understanding a word he said.
What do you study, George?
Read a lot. Love a good mystery. Good mystery is my tonic.
Good God. Look at the time. Should go and flag down that bus.
Someone coming in on the 735?
My sister, Laura.
Many times I picked my boy Robert up off the 735. Should just be coming over the hill.
I think I can see the lights.
You better hurry.
One more thing I should mention before I go, George.
Yeah.
Just checking the directions.
Well, hope you like the country life.
Oh, I'm sure we will. Just takes a little getting used to. Did Greg tell you I just got out of the hospital? Is that what he told you?
He mentioned something about it. Look, Mrs. Sanderson.
You must understand, I've lived in the city my whole life. There could be bears and wolves out there, for all I know.
No. No bears and wolves.
Well, that's good. What about snakes?
No, there's no poisonous snakes either. Once they catch that leopard, there'll be nothing around here that can hurt you.
A what?
Leopard. Escape from that safari park thing they have up near Hillsboro. It's a small one, mind you, though it has been eating lots of livestock.
Oh dear. You see, I'm not very good when it comes to animals.
Don't worry. Left you a shotgun just in case.
That thing works?
You bet it does. It's old, but it'll blast that critter into fur balls. Catch it alive, and there is a reward, though.
This is just all too much. First blood and ghosts, now some wild animal on the loose.
Mrs. Sanderson, I'm sorry about all these stories. There's really nothing around here that can hurt you. Generally, things are quite peaceful.
You call this peaceful?
Sure. Nothing bad's happened around here recently. Not since, Charlie Reese got murdered.
Murdered?
Someone lopped his head off with a chainsaw.
Who would lop someone's head off with a chainsaw?
No one I knew. Some argument about a tree? But, generally folks are quite peaceful.
Well, I've never heard of anybody in the city lopping someone's head off with a chainsaw.
That's because city folk have no imagination. In the city, you get stuck with knives, have your brains blown out with guns. Dull. In the country, you can have a tractor fall on your head, get cut to pieces by a combine, drown in a grain silo, even drive your snowmobile straight through a fence, just like cheese wire. Now, dozens of ways to catch it, and no two ways around it. Take that to a knife in the gut any day.
Yes.
Sure nice of your sister-in-law to come down, help you get the place all spick and span.
To be honest with you, George, I wish you wasn't coming.
Oh?
You see, Laura and I don't exactly get along. I don't know. Maybe I'm just oversensitive.
Nothing wrong with being sensitive.
But it always seems to get me into trouble.
That's funny. I'm always told I'm not sensitive enough. Can't win, can ya?
Oh, George. You seem to be very sensitive. I also think you're very honest.
Oh, thank you. I like to think of myself as honest. But you never know, as that Sherlock Holmes fellows used to say. You should never theorize before having all the facts. I could be a loony for all you know. Beg your pardon, Mrs.
George, are you a good judge of character?
I'd say so.
Could you do me a favor?
Sure.
It's Laura. She has some strange effect over Greg. See if you can... Never mind, old girl. Check coffee.
What a beautiful place. You must be George.
Right, first time.
I'm Laura, Greg's sister.
Pleased to meet you. Hope you like her out here.
I'm sure I will. It's so exciting. I've never lived in the country before.
Well, you'll find lots of nice walks around here, fresh air, straight off the lake. In no time, you'll be as happy as a pig in shit.
Jan, you're looking terrific. It's been a long time.
So it has. I was going to come visit you in the hospital, but the doctors advised against it. How are you feeling?
Much better, thanks.
That's good. I hope you don't mind me barging in so soon. I hope Greg explained.
He tells me you're going out west.
Yes, it's a big step. But I think it's the right thing for my career. Well, I guess I'll take my bags upstairs.
No. Let me take them.
Thank you. So, how old is this house, George?
I don't rightly know. Been here as long as I can remember.
It's probably haunted, too.
So they say.
I love haunted houses.
You believe in ghosts?
No, it's the atmosphere I like.
I see.
I believe in ghosts.
Well, then you'll like this house best of all.
That coffee must be ready. Laura, would you like some?
No, thank you.
Greg.
Yes, please. Well, what do you think?
Gorgeous. A lot better now.
Oh, you've seen it before?
No. Better than what I imagined it would look.
I won't spill it this time.
Thanks, Jan. Oh, God, that's awful. What are you trying to do, poison me?
I'm sorry, I don't know what happened.
Must have parked too long.
Oh. Greg, I'm really sorry.
It's all right, Jan. It's just a cup of coffee.
Let me make it. I know exactly how Greg likes his coffee.
No, I'll be making Greg his coffee, not you.
It's all right, Jen. It's really not that bad.
I was only trying to help.
I'm just out of practice, that's all.
That's perfectly understandable. And Laura was only trying to help.
That's all, Jen, really.
Why don't you let her make the coffee?
All right.
That's why I drink whiskey. Leave the making to others.
Oh, George, I'm just being silly.
Don't worry. I bet in a couple of days you'll be making coffee so good, even I'd drink it. Not making any promises, though.
You shouldn't be long now. You know, I've really been looking forward to this. No deadlines, no rush.
Yes, I was looking forward to it, too.
That's great, Jen. You know, I really want us to be friends. That's all I've ever wanted. One big, happy family.
Sounds terrific. Shall I play the wife, or shall you? What did you have for breakfast?
The usual. Vitamins A, B, C, D12, riboflavin, and some minerals. Manganese, phosphorus, copper, and iron.
Honey, I'm surprised you don't rust. I see your diet's ruining you.
Is there some hidden meaning in that remark? Are you referring to last night?
Fat. Well, a little raw meat will help that along.
It's just been a while. You know, you don't expect a car to start that's been sitting in the driveway for 4 months, do you?
Well, I wasn't much help either, but I still think a good breakfast would work wonders.
Maybe some other time.
You always loved my cooking. At least try some.
Maybe when I get back. I'll go for a run.
You're not leaving until I feed you.
What is this? Some compulsive maternal neurosis? Give me my shoe.
A barbaric breakfast of bacon and eggs.
Give it back!
Fresh muffins and fresh coffee.
Morning, sis. How'd you sleep?
Terrible. It was too damn quiet.
Well, since you're up, do you want to have breakfast with me?
I will. Thank you.
Well, I'm going to go for a run and catch the last of this light. It's beautiful this time of morning.
Stay and talk with me for a while.
Maybe when I get back.
Greg, sit. Relax. How is your work going?
Fine.
Making any progress?
A bit.
What's the matter?
Look, what happened to that guy you were going out with? That account executive.
I'm an account executive. He's a copywriter.
Still, what happened to him?
You know what happened. The same thing always happens. What are you bringing this up for?
I just sometimes wonder if you ever even try.
Of course I'd try. You think this is easy for me after all we've been through? I just can't relate to these men.
And that's my fault, I suppose? And as always, you come crawling back to me.
Oh, is that how you see it? Well, you just say the words and I'll go. I'll move to the other side of the continent if that's what you want.
You'll always come back, Laura.
Oh, yes. Well, I can make more money in one day than you'll ever make with your stupid rocks. Greg, I'm proud of your work. You know that.
You just can't expect me to survive out there on my own, not after all I've been through.
Guess I should be heading off.
See ya.
You know, that was significant. That was very significant.
What is?
Oh, Greg hasn't been like this for years. When we first met, oh, we would laugh. He had the craziest sense of humor, but you hardly ever see it these days. You know, it may seem like we've had nothing but our problems, but we were once very, very happy. It was when your mother died last fall that everything changed. Greg just stopped talking. He wouldn't say a word for days, and I would try to help, but wouldn't end up feeling just more and more inadequate.
It was a very emotional time for all of us.
It's at the funeral that everything changed. That's what I don't understand.
Perhaps after you saw the coffin. It was an emotional time, but you mustn't take it as rejection towards you. I'm sure he still loved you.
Really, did he say so?
Well, no, but I'm sure he did.
All these months of white people and white walls.
You can't expect everything to be as it was, Jan.
It's the feeling, Laura, that's all I ask. Why, it's been years since...
Since he...
Just held me in his arms.
He did what exactly?
I'd taken a shredding shoe, he chased me, held me in his arms, and then you were there. Surely you remember.
You must be thinking of a different time. Or maybe you dreamt it?
You think I'm hallucinating, don't you?
No, Jan, it's understandable. You've always had a vivid imagination.
Well, damn it happened, you're lying.
You know what, it makes no difference to me. It happened. I think I'll go upstairs and get dressed now.
Dr. Kate Sinclair, Tape 2, Side 1, April 15th. Hi, Kate. Well, we've only been here a day and already there's been a situation. You see, I'm convinced I saw Greg do something, but Laura, yes, Laura, can you believe that she's here already, says that it didn't happen. I don't know what I should think, Kate. Should I confront Greg about it? Did it really happen? Hello? Who is... Oh my God!
Who was it?
Oh my God, it's horrible!
Well, who was it?
There's some man breathing heavily into the phone.
Hello? It's Greg. What? He's out of breath.
What?
Yes. The White Farmhouse? I can see it. Yes, I'm sure it wasn't there yesterday. Okay, I'll come pick you up. Well, at least you weren't imagining it.
Laura, can I come with you? I'm feeling a bit on edge.
No, you stay here and go.
Please, Laura, I can't be left alone. I get these panic attacks.
How do you expect to recover from this if all you do is run away? Now you stay here and relax.
Please, Laura.
I'll only be gone a few minutes. I'll be back before midnight, just for you. Look who's here.
Hi, everybody.
Keep you company.
I brought some turnips.
That's very kind of you.
Hey, look, if you ever need anything picked up in town, don't hesitate to ask.
Oh, Laura's just on her way to pick up Greg. He fell in a ditch, apparently.
Just now?
Yes.
How did he fall into a ditch in broad daylight?
Well, you see, he goes jogging. And he sweats a lot, and his glasses steam up. Can't see where he's going. The truth is, he needs a lot of looking after. He eats these vitamins just to survive. All he really cares about are his stupid rocks.
Hey, I'm sure he cares a lot about you too.
Oh, I'm sure he would, if I were 10,000 years old. Anyways, would you like a drink? Coffee?
Well, I must admit to a powerful thirst, but doctor's orders.
No coffee.
Quite right.
Or tea.
Very sensitive stomach.
Well, I suppose it's a bit early for alcohol.
I know, but doctor's orders.
I'll get you some water with it.
Don't use the water around here. It's full of chemicals, all the fertilizer we use.
Well, you'll have to have it straight then.
Quite right, I should.
Just say when.
When? Whatever. I'll force it down.
I go put some music on. Was there anything interesting on the news this morning?
Nothing really. There was an accident up near Thornby. One of the McCulloch boys got himself killed.
Oh dear.
It's no surprise, really. They're a damn fool family, if you ask me. Robert knew the other boy. Got a lot of idiot notions from him, too. Tried to convince him to buy a motorcycle and go to California or some such nonsense.
Did you talk him out of it?
I thumped him out of it.
Oh. Well, was there anything else on the news?
There, was this one story from the city you may be interested in. This boy poisoned his entire family to death, bit by bit, putting antimony in their pills. Turns out, antimony can give you what looks like a heart attack, but leaves no trace. Only found him out because they were wondering why the kid was buying so much of the stuff.
You mean it's possible to poison someone without the doctors being able to trace it?
Sure is. Yeah. Makes you think, don't it?
It certainly does. George, have you ever been in a situation where you thought something had happened, but it hadn't?
Seeing things?
More like dreams, but you're awake.
Well, can't say that I have. There are things that are real and things that aren't. Ain't nothing in between.
Well, for some of us, George, our whole life seems to be the in-between. I mean, you said yourself this house was full of ghosts.
Oh, Mrs. Anderson, these ghost stories, they make for a good TV show, a story. That's all they are. I mean, you say that before you see a ghost, not after.
You're right, George. I'm just being stupid.
Well, I should be on my way. Thanks for that coffee.
George, I just wanted to let you know that I think of you as a friend.
Glad you feel that way.
I just get frightened out here on my own.
Don't worry. I'm just across the road if you ever need anything. Don't hesitate to call. Bye for now.
Goodbye, George.
I don't know what happened. It just appeared out of nowhere, I guess.
Just lay down and relax. Jan, sit in the chair. Jan, wake up.
Is she all right?
She's out cold. She's been into the pills again.
How many did she take?
Relax. There's only a couple missing.
I don't like switching the pills. In fact, it worries the hell out of me.
Just relax. No one's going to find out.
She might notice the difference. For God's sake, she's flat on her back.
Just relax. She'll be fine.
I just wonder about all this. You know? She seems so much better.
She's not better. They managed to patch her up 4 months of therapy, but don't kid yourself. She'll never be better.
It's not entirely her fault. If you and I hadn't met up again at the funeral...
What are you saying? Are you saying that I'm the one that caused her breakdowns? Is that what you're saying?
No. Of course not. But you didn't help them either.
These depressants are totally self-indulged. She could fight them, but she won't. If she really cared about you, she'd fight them. All she could do dare to do was stare at a white wall. For God's sake, she didn't remember who you were.
But she recovered, didn't she?
Yes, but next time you won't, she won't. Remember, you've always needed someone strong. Remember, I was the one who was there for you. I gave you support and comfort while she was a frothing imbecile. Greg, why don't you kiss me anymore?
She's still my wife. You know?
You want me to go? Fine, I'll go. Just remember, Mom and Dad are dead, and all you have left is me.
Laura!
Fall asleep, I'll get her these damn nightmares.
Take some of your pills.
No. I think I'll make some hot chocolate. Do you want some?
No.
What the hell is going on down here?
Dreams.
Has she taken her Librium?
She doesn't want to.
It's past 5 in the morning, for God's sakes.
The peace of country living, eh?
I'm sorry, did I wake you up as well?
No, I just came down to water the plants.
Well, I made some hot chocolate. Do you want some?
No, thank you.
Well, she's mad at me.
Jan, she's not mad at you. She's just not her best at 5 in the morning.
Oh, I see. It's my fault I woke her up. Well, if she wasn't here, I wouldn't be having these damn nightmares to begin with.
Jan.
How is a man who's so supposed to be so smart be so dumb? Can't you see the way she manipulates you? You're blind to everything she does.
You make me sound like an insensitive clod.
At last he understands.
Look, I know I'm not perfect.
No kidding!
I may be a bit insensitive sometimes, but you've got to give me a chance.
All right, what do you want to talk about?
Tell me about your dream.
But you don't understand them.
I can try.
All right. I was dreaming about spiders. It's horrible. There was thousands of them, and they were small and black. And they were climbing, crawling through the windows and the doors, and soon they were going up the stairs and into the bedroom, and then they were crawling all over me. I couldn't breathe.
You know, that's fascinating.
Greg, it's not fascinating.
It is. It's probably because of that story in the paper yesterday.
I didn't read the paper yesterday.
Oh, it was amazing. It seems there was this woman.
Is this going to be gory?
No, no. It's a miracle. There was this woman. She went on a cruise to the tropics. After about a week, this big sore developed in her face. No one knew what it was, trying to figure it out, but they couldn't. After a little while, it just popped.
Ew.
And all these little spiders came out of it. They've been nesting, you see. No one knew they could nest like that. It's amazing, really.
That is disgusting.
It's just a story.
Well, that is the most revolting story I've ever heard.
I was just trying to help.
Sure. You know, you're the sick one. You're the one who should be in the hospital, not me.
Jen, we mustn't squabble like this. We came to the country to get closer.
Then get rid of that damn sister of yours.
But why?
Because she hates me.
Jen, that's nonsense.
Get rid of her, Greg. With her here, I'll never recover.
It really means a lot to me that you two patch things up.
Do I have to spell it out to you? With her here, I will never recover. Get rid of her.
What can I tell her?
The truth.
I can't do that.
Then I don't care. Make something up. She's not out of here by tomorrow. I'm checking myself back into the hospital.
Jan, it's 5 a.m. It's hardly the right time to be making big decisions like this.
You think I can't see what's going on here? All I ask is for a chance to get things going between us again, but we can't if she's here. How could you bring that vile woman here knowing how I feel about her? Is it because you don't want to be alone with me? Is that it?
Of course not. If I didn't want to be with you, I would have divorced you.
You would have divorced me if it hadn't been for my father. Yes. He's been very useful to you, hasn't he? Getting you all these scholarships and research grants. But what happens when your precious thesis is finished? I'll be out in the back with the rest of your discarded lumps of rock.
Do you really believe that?
I'm beginning to.
Jan, I haven't divorced you because I believe our marriage can work.
It won't work with her here.
Will you just be reasonable?
That's it. You and Laura can set up house.
Will you just listen to me?
No, you listen. I'm going to go check myself back into the hospital. And you know what that means, don't you? It means I can check myself out whenever I feel like it. Not when you and Laura decide the time is right. Where are the car keys?
I'll ask her to leave.
Ask?
I'll tell her to leave. First thing in the morning.
You won't let her talk you out of it.
No. Whatever helps you get better.
I feel better already.
I'm going to bed. You coming?
No, I think I'll stay up for a while.
Good night then.
Hi, Kate. You won't believe this, but it's 5:30 in the morning. And I'm convinced there's a conspiracy against me. Or at least I was until a few moments ago. It's like she's got a strange hold over him and there's nothing I can do to stop it. But he's promised me he's going to send her away in the morning, and I'm hoping that this will be the end of it. Kate, they keep telling me that my illness is coming back. And the most frightening thing is, what if they're right?
Jan, what is it? What's wrong?
What's going on now?
A fuse blew, I think. I'll get the lights. Jan?
Is she all right?
I don't know. Just passed out, I think. Jan?
I'll get her some water.
Are you all right? What happened?
I saw a man.
Inside?
Yes, he must have come through that doorway. He had a knife.
It's locked from the inside.
Well, then he must still be in here. Check the house.
There's no one in here, Jen.
He has to still be in here. Check the basement.
To think, the old hermit's ghost is sitting in our basement.
Greg. Well, just take the gun. He had a knife.
Oh, yeah, right.
You think I'm having another breakdown, don't you?
I said I'll go check. Just calm down, okay?
Well, there has been dirt, footprints, anything.
I heard screams. Is everything all right?
We had a prowler.
That's all? Looks more like a pajama party, don't it?
Well, he wasn't just any prowler. He had a knife.
Why, that little beggar. Probably one of those local kids. After that stereophonic system of yours. All the kids want these days. Robert was always bugging me to get him one. Well, now he's in the city. Probably up to his ass in stereophonic systems, no doubt.
Well, this prowler was like old and grotesque.
Sounds just like my son. Tell you what, I'll check outside for footprints. I read a book by that Sherlock Holmes fella, Hounds of the Basketballs or something like that. So I know how it's done.
Would it frighten anyone if I lit a cigarette?
There's no one downstairs, Jen. I hope this puts your fears to rest.
No one's trying to hurt you, Jen. If only you would have taken your pills, none of this would have happened.
Why don't you take your pills now?
I'll get them.
Well, traditionally, footprints are found in the soft earth under the windowsill, right? But in this case, there aren't any. Although I do have an explanation for that.
And what's that?
I'm standing on concrete. Maybe it was a ghost. Came straight through the walls. Well, whatever it was, it's gone now.
I'm sorry we got you up, George.
Don't worry about it. I was up already. Is there any more problems? Is gun loaded?
Yes,
good. Use it. Pepper his hide. Give him a little country hospitality. Well, good night.
Well, I hope this puts all your fears to rest. I think we can all go to bed now.
I'm not tired.
You're not? Well, I certainly am. Good night.
Those pills of yours should be working by now. Jen, what are you doing? You look ridiculous.
I'll sleep during the day.
You're gonna stay up all night. Cradling a shotgun?
That's right.
Fine. Just don't blow a hole in the wall shooting at some figment of your imagination.
I'd like to see how this figment likes lead in its belly.
Closer. I have a gun.
God. What have you done? It's Laura. She's dead. She's dead!
Keep away from me.
Jen, she's dead. Can't you see what you've done? Oh, God. Laura.
She was trying to kill me and you knew about it.
She wouldn't try to kill you, Jen. Jesus. Jesus!
She has a knife.
What are you talking about?
She must have a knife.
There's no knife. Please, Jen, put the gun down.
I've only shot one barrel, you know? This gun's still loaded.
Is that what you want? You want to kill me too?
I want to know the truth. What was going on between you and Laura?
Nothing, damn it! She wouldn't try to kill you.
Is that why you guys put poison in my pills?
Poison?
Do you remember when I was out cold on the couch? Well, I was awake, and I heard every word you said. I thought someone had been tampering with my pills, and it turns out I was right.
It wasn't poison. Laura said they needed stronger tranquilizers. Your pills weren't working, you were beginning to relapse.
So you were trying to poison me?
No, goddammit, I wasn't! Look, I didn't agree with it anyway. You heard that too, didn't you?
Why don't you just tell me the truth?
Jan, she's dead. There'll be time for explanations later.
Later, I won't have a gun.
Jan?
Just get back.
I'm not gonna hurt you.
Then why did you carry on with her? Behind my back? And while I was in the hospital, what were you two doing then?
Nothing. We barely even saw each other.
Yes, but who looked after you? Who gave you support and comfort while your wife was a frothing imbecile? Why don't you kiss me anymore, Greg? You know, all these months of me asking you what the matter was, and you saying nothing was the matter, and then a doctor saying that nothing was the matter.
How could I have told you? You'd have walked right out on me.
No, I wouldn't.
If I'd cared less about you, it would have been easier. I just couldn't bring myself to tell you. And when Laura said she was moving out west, I thought she wanted to reconcile things with you, and I believed her.
The power was out. She didn't say a word.
Jen, once you and I got married, I told Laura it was over. I didn't even see her again until the funeral.
I would have understood if only you'd talked to me.
I wanted to talk to you about it, but I was confused. I couldn't do it. Just, you've got to believe me, please.
Well, we sure botched up this big reunion, didn't we?
Yeah. Yeah, I guess so.
Greg, I'm sorry. I didn't know it was her.
I love you. I don't always show it, but I do.
Well, could you phone the police? I don't have the nerve right now.
You realize what this means, don't you? This is the end of the road for us. They'll put you away for a long time for this.
But surely they'll understand.
Understand what? That she was trying to kill you? Where's the knife? Where's the gun? And wasn't it a man you claim you saw? What do you expect them to think? Jan! Jan, come down here!
What's the matter? Did you phone?
No.
Greg, what are you thinking?
Annoying. I mean, there's certain rules. At a given angle of strike, the fracture should have certain fixed properties.
But they don't?
No. These stupid rocks please themselves. Where have you been?
Would you like some coffee?
No.
Tea.
Jan, I asked where you've been.
I was just outside.
Were you in the garden again?
I was just checking.
If George sees you fussing around in the garden all the time, he's gonna suspect something. What's the matter with you?
I'm sorry, but I can't help this feeling that the body isn't properly covered.
It's buried plenty deep enough. Buried it myself.
I had a dream last night that the body wasn't covered. There was an arm sticking out. And no matter what I did, I just couldn't cover it.
Really getting fed up with your damn dreams.
How can you be like this when there's a dead body out there?
For God's sakes.
I've got this terrible urge to see it. I have to stop myself from clawing at it with my bare hands.
That's it, Jen. You're gonna have to stay inside.
No!
You've gotta keep away from that body.
Please, Greg, let's just leave this house.
We can't. I told you. Once she's decomposed, we can dig up her bones and burn them. We're both accessories to her murder now. Don't forget that.
I'll go mad if we stay here.
The point is, we don't have a choice.
Well, I have to do something to calm myself down.
Take some of your pills. I'm going for a run.
No, Greg, don't leave me here. It's almost dark.
Take your damn pills. They relieve your tension and running relieves mine. Look, I'm sorry. My nerves are pretty raw too right now. Just remember what the alternatives are. We'll make it through this.
If only we could just tell them the truth.
The point is, we can't do that anymore. You're gonna have to get used to that.
Greg? Greg, come down here.
What is it?
Look at the floor.
What, did you spill something?
No, it's that stain George talked about.
It's just some damp coming up through the floor. It's fine.
I cleaned up every trace of Laura's blood.
It's not blood. Laura's body's buried beneath the garden, for God's sakes.
George said the stain returns whenever there's been a murder. When he sees it, he'll know.
It's not that stain. Laura's been dead a week, for God's sakes.
Well, then what is it?
I don't know. Will you just clean it up and stop asking stupid questions?
Well, it sure looks like blood. God! Greg! Get the door!
Don't panic!
Thought you were having a party in here, judging by all the noise.
Ah, George. Come in. Haven't seen you in a few days.
Well, it's spring. Things are getting busy around here. By the way, I noticed your garden on the way in.
What about it?
Coming up beautifully. Much faster than mine. What are you using as fertilizer?
Just natural things, George.
Amazing. Nothing special?
Nope. Just natural things. Some dead leaves, manure, anything that'll decompose, really.
Well, you certainly have a green thumb, I'll give you that.
Would you like a drink? The usual.
What say now? You know, it's a shame your sister-in-law had to leave so soon. You'll be right pretty around here in the next couple of weeks. Just stopped in to let you know I'll be gone for the next couple of days. My brother in Milston is sick, and I said I'd go down and help out.
Well, I'll miss having you around to liven the place up.
Oh, I'm sure you'll get along famously on your own. I should also let you know I let myself in the other day and fixed some of the faulty wiring. It's just a patch job, but my boy Robert will fix it up properly when he's home.
That's very kind of you, George. Listen, I'm going to go out and catch the last of this light, but you stay here, relax, have another drink, and Jen will keep you company.
All this running around, what's it about?
Jogging. Oh, Greg just does it to keep fit, that's all.
Just runs in a big circle then?
That's right.
Falls down a lot, don't he? Hardly seems worth it.
Oh, Greg enjoys it. Keeps his mind off other things.
Oh, I know what you mean, Mrs. Physical work is very important for that. If I didn't put in my hard day's work, well, it's been a long time since my wife departed.
Oh, George, I didn't know your wife was dead.
She ain't dead. Just departed.
Oh. Well, that's sad.
Sure is. She's a wonderful wife. That old bitch.
Well, it is certainly hard living in the country if your heart isn't in it.
There sure weren't. God, told her the farm life suited her. Put her in a field full of cows and it would take you 10 minutes to figure out which one was her.
Surely she wasn't that bad.
No. She did have some amazing powers, though. She'd bring home young shoots, replant them, water them, talk to them even. And before you know it, poof, they'd be dead. Nope. If I had a wife like you, my life would have been very different.
Is she in the city now?
Somewhere.
Then she must see much of Robert.
You don't want to see her.
Huh.
Hello. What's this? There's a shotgun pellet embedded in this chair.
How strange.
I varnished this chair just before you came up. No shotgun pellets in it.
Huh.
Yeah, there seems to be some more over here. Definitely came from one direction. Any idea how this could have happened?
Not a clue. I'm mystified by it all.
Well, as that Sherlock Holmes fellow always used to say, there's but one step from the grotesque to the horrible.
What's that got to do with this?
Nothing. That's always what he used to say. I'll check the gun.
Oh, no, I'm sure there's a perfectly good.
Nope, hasn't been fired.
Well, I'll ask Greg about it. Perhaps he did it by accident.
Yeah, that's probably what happened.
Listen, George, did you mail that package I gave you?
Yeah, I did. Sure weighed a ton. What was in it?
Tapes. Cassette tapes. I recite into them for my therapist. It's a lot easier than writing a letter.
That's, very interesting. Look, Mrs. Sanderson, both a gunshot.
I wouldn't worry yourself about it, George, really.
Well, all right.
Would you like another drink?
No. I should be on my way. My brother's expecting me.
Can you stay just a little bit longer until Greg gets back?
I promised him I'd be there by supper time. You'll be fine on your own. I'm only gone a couple of days. Bye for now.
Good night, George. God, I hate this house. I hate it when it gets dark. All of my senses begin to tingle. My hands begin to sweat. I feel like I'm beginning to lose control. You know, sounds are different when you have company. The creaking of a floorboard, tapping of a branch against a window. But when you're alone, well, they aren't so ordinary, are they? And I guess that's what loneliness is all about. I should just do those exercises you showed me. No. No, I'm okay. Here. Yes. Yes, I'm sorry. Just, that's okay. Okay. Jan? That's my name. Kate, I think I'm going crazy. The electric company. Yes, hello. You have an emergency service, don't you? Well, this certainly constitutes as an emergency. All my power is out. You don't expect me to spend the rest of the night in the dark, do you? Yes, the 5th concession road. Yes, the Willoughby Farm. Oh, you know George. Oh. No! Don't send anyone here. No, I'm sure it's just one of the power lines. Check them. George said that his son Robert will be by in a few days to check the wiring here, so there isn't any need. Yes, that's what he said. How long ago? Yes, you're right. My mistake. Okay.
Ah!
It's me! Oh my God, it's me! It's me!
Jan?
Yes, it's me.
Are you all right?
I'm fine. Where have you been?
Why didn't you come looking for me? I could have died out there.
I took some pills. They knocked me out.
I don't know what happened. I was just running and someone must have hit me. Everything just went black. I guess you know what's behind that door then. How could you drag her out of the garden like that?
She's dead?
Of course she's dead.
Oh my God. George must have set this whole thing up.
George?
You know that son he always talks about, Robert? Well, Robert went missing years ago. The locals think he was murdered. They never found the body.
How did you find this out?
I phoned the electric company, and that's when they told me. Oh God, Greg, he set the whole thing up. The blood, the ghost. He even has all of my tapes. He even knows.
He must know about Laura. Let's get out of here before he comes back.
You were right, Robert. He was a fine boy. Bought this place for him, but he didn't want it. Wanted to go live in the city with that bitch mother of his. No, I know you city types, but I reckon you ain't too smart. You two are gonna be my masterpiece. With all your psychological problems, it'll just look like a murder-suicide. So perfect, really. May even give up my job as head ghost.
Looks like the tables are turned, George.
You think so, eh? Now I agree with you. If the gun was in your wife's hands, but not you, Greg. I'm a pretty good judge of character. And I'd say you're too spineless to fire that thing. Not like your murderous wife.
What? Get back!
Just give me the gun, Greg. You could tear a hole right through a human being, Greg. That's blood and guts. That's reality. Can't turn your back on that.
Don't give it to him, Greg.
So easy.
No! Keep the light on him. He's not breathing.
Well, we have to call the police now. When they see the knife, they'll know what he was up to.
What about Laura?
George killed her. You covered it up to protect me.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. Call them.
Ah! Old farmer's open at you again, hey, Craig? Well, I checked the shotgun earlier. Make sure there were blanks in it. So easy, really. Go for it, Greg! Come on! Go for it!
Aim the light in his eyes!
Oh my God! Greg, stop! Just stop it! He's dead.
Oh my God.
Oh, Greg.
It's okay. It's over. You're safe.
Greg, what are you doing?
Just trying to relax you.
Greg, that really hurts.
You're hallucinating.
Stop, okay? I can't breathe.
Wake up.
Stop.
Wake up.
Stop it. No. No, not you. Not you two. Not...
Jeff, look at me! She's gone. Jesus. I thought she was never gonna break. Get the lights, George.
Give me the lights. I'll get the whiskey.
Do as you're told.
Storm must have blown the damn thing out.
Forget it then.
Thanks. Good stuff, this. Well, everything went according to plan.
Yeah. Although, I don't know what we would have done if she'd held on much longer. God, we spent hours working on those tapes. I thought she was gonna crack when she saw Laura hanging in the doorway, let alone hearing her voice.
Still don't know why you wanted to do it. She seems so harmless.
Of course you don't understand. Your wife deserted you. Your son deserted you. Or tried to, anyway.
You're a failure. How could you possibly understand someone like me? These bitches never left me alone. Laura picked up where my mother left off, and Jan, well, I admit, I married her for less than romantic reasons. I'd always thought they'd end up destroying each other, given half a chance. But it wasn't until I discovered Robert's body in the quarry, I realized I had everything I needed. The perfect house, and a less than perfect accomplice.
You're a real bastard.
I'm not a murderer. Not like you, George.
To hell you're not! I got mad. I went crazy. I don't even remember doing it. But you've been planning this for months. You killed your own sister in cold blood!
I didn't kill her. I didn't pull the trigger.
Laura thought there were gonna be blanks in the gun. If I'd known she was gonna die, I would have had no part in this.
Poor Laura. If only I'd checked the gun a little more carefully. You see, George, smart people never do anything they can get someone else to do for them. Think of this all as an experiment in scientific probability.
Well, I hope you're happy. Making, give my money and I can go.
One problem there, George.
No, you promised 20,000.
Are you insane? I don't have that kind of money. Why do you think we've been doing this whole charade? So I can go back to playing the poor, long-suffering son-in-law? I don't have a cent, George. Without my grants and scholarships, I'd have to work for a living.
So you were lying to me all along?
Yup, I was. You see, George, at first I felt bad. But then I thought, why pay all this money to a guy who goes around murdering kids?
I'll kill you for that! Oh.
Great stuff, this. Hey, George. Antimony. Leaves no trace. Remember? You see, after you tried to scare my poor wife and I as the old hermit, your heart just couldn't take it. And remember, Laura? Oh, yes. As I recall, she went out west a week ago. And who was it that took her to the bus stop? Oh, I believe that was you. When they find her body buried next to Robert's in the quarry. I don't need to tell you what they'll think. You've been a naughty boy, George. But you're about to become a part of the perfect crime. Post-mortem, of course. Guess there's just one more job for the old coot to do. Hang in there, Laura. You're about to meet Robert. You don't like him. He's just your type. Jen?
Thank you.